And we're close to a start with the Lady is a Vamp to move forward into the gates at the 1,000-metre shoot. Crown Perth handicap. Lights on. Set. Racing. Frankie Drake was a little bit slow to begin, and Capital Flight began brilliantly and has bounced on the lead from Yemen Last State of Power. Beads is going to drive through and be right on the back of Capital Flight early. Frankie Drake has picked up. It's over on the inside, and further back in the field is Thomas Magnum as they run down the side of the track with about 650 metres to go. Well back in the field, the Lady is the Vamp. It's over on the inside and being covered by Storm Commander, who's near the back of the field as they come up to the turn, and Forever Autumn was racing about fifth or sixth out wider as they bend. Capital Flight has got the lead. Beads Hard on its back. State of Power is on the outside. Then came Yemen Lass. Back behind them, Forever Autumn is coming down the outside. Inside the 250, Capital Flight in front. Beads is giving chase through the centre, and so is State of Power. And then came Forever Autumn. Capital Flight's in front. State of Power and Beads, they're both trying very hard. Capital Flight is clinging on. Beads will lunge late, but Capital Flight's in front. State of Power, Beads come, but Capital Flight's done it again. Four in a row and beat State of Power and Beads. Forever Autumn was wide out with Thomas Magnum from Storm Commander. The Lady is the Vamp, Yemen Lass, and tailing off is Big Frankie Drake. Capital Flight looks to have just won. Ooh, has it? It looks to have just won. Gee, that's close. Didn't realise this horse has got that close. State of Power on the outside. Capital Flight looked to cling on. State of Power diving at it. Ooh, this is very close. I thought to the naked eye, Capital Flight, and it has won it. Number two, Capital Flight is first. Well, there was a very worrying shot there that seemed to give State of Power potentially a winning hope there, but the other two shots had a nose margin for Capital Flight, and there it is. That got tremendously close. Beads, I thought, was the one coming through, and it was, but then it just started to peter out the final 25, and then State of Power started to surge on the outside and has just missed. So Capital Flight maintains this winning run, but you wouldn't want it over again if you're a punter there with Capital Flight. It has just scraped in by City Place, the American bred Flying Affair, the mare by Heritage, Bayor Brown Gelding for F. Maynard, T. Haddleton, D. Roke, and Yarradale Stud. Sayers, and 34-44 the last 600, 59-28. It's a nose officially, a nose by a short neck. And it's scrambled in Brittany, but gave the punters a bit of a heart attack.
I know, it looked to the naked eye like it was a very obvious win, and then when you looked at that photo, it was a little bit closer than perhaps you would have liked her in as you joined me. Were you comfortable on the line? Knew you'd got it?
No. Someone said the inside. I said, were we on the inside? Yep, okay. Yeah, so no, it was pretty close.
It's been an extraordinary journey with this horse. One, I know when we spoke last time, the lofty expectations, the bar was set very, very low. You weren't expecting big things from this horse, and here you are, four in a line and a winner in town now. Can you believe it?
No, well, we bought him as a yearling, so it's actually nice that we've actually brought him all the way through. And obviously, Ronnie had a share. Well, they've got a share in him. So it's a shame that, you know, he didn't win a race before. Yeah, things happen, so yeah.
That is a shame, but I'm sure the family's still enjoying watching Capital Flight go around, as you are with the success that he's having. How have you viewed his progression?
He's certainly woken up, that's for sure, because we didn't think he'd ever be racing on a sad day. I think his work ethic has definitely changed over the last probably three or four starts, so yeah.
Have you had a look at the calendar? What's next for him?
There is one in a fortnight, which we might, it's a 66 though, so plus, so I'm not sure, depending on his rating, and it's either that or we'll tip him out because he's finished with his West Speed as a three-year-old. We thought we might just race him up until August and then just maybe 4 weeks, 6 weeks spell, and then come back in maybe for the summer scorcher or something, so yeah.
Now it's, where did you originally say, what track were you thinking that he would be racing at?
Well, I was thinking of taking long service leave and maybe heading to Broome or Roeburn. So
going from Roeburn and now we're talking a summer scorcher. What an incredible progression it has been. Well done.
Thank you.
There is Kareem Maynard, Capital Flight. Well, what a journey, Scott, to think maybe we'll have a little horse for Broome or Roeburn on some dirt tracks. And here we are talking about the potential of a race like a summer scorcher. It's great to see what this horse has been able to do. And Luke Campbell had been obviously riding him and handling him really well. Luke unable to ride on a Saturday at this stage of his apprenticeship. But Brandon Louis, the beneficiary of that, and handled him to perfection today.
A wonderful ride too, Britt, because we've obviously seen this horse last two starts sprint from off the pace. And Brandon Louis just copped a hoof to the foot there. So that'll teach him for taking photos before he comes and does interviews, Britt. He'll learn from that one, but that's going to be ginger in the morning, I would say. But for now, he can live off that adrenaline because this horse has given him a Metro double because he was able to lift home Fanta earlier on by a narrow margin, and he's been able to do the same here on Capital Flight. So this horse's last two has been able to sprint over them from the back of the field. And today, when the leader came out this morning in My Baby Blue Jean, he's able to take luck out of the equation, roll to the top, and then kick into the home straight. Got a little bit tight in the last couple of strides there for him, but Capital Flight does the job. Today, Brandon, coming into the race, first ride for you. Where were you probably expecting to be in the run?
To be honest, after the scratching of My Baby Blue, I think I was sort of, me and Corinne, we were sort of a bit wary where we want to go, but watching the pattern of all the races today, and I won one before going forward, and I told Corinne that he's on pace going today, so we just, if nobody wants to go, we just go there, we rate the horse, and if he's good enough, we will hang on.
Did you realise how close it got in that last stride?
I was going, again, like, the more I was going, I can see they are coming, and I just say, all right, if you're good enough, you will win, mate, you know? So anyway, he lift the last 100 metres, he really lift to get there, so it's a good horse. And special mention to Luke Campbell, because normally that's his ride, so he told me the horse will go as good, so anyway.
And what about personally too? Because it's a Metro double here. It's a big achievement.
Yes, exactly. So I think that's my first Metro double in WA. And I'm just appreciate the moment now. And I just hope it continue.
Congratulations. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Beautifully spoken, Brandon Louis. And particularly nice to get that nod to Luke Campbell. Very classy there as Capital Flight takes out race number 7.